this run of Oak is for you guys. This is going to be a blast. Did I cherry pick perfect logs for this run? Yes, I did. Why did I do it? Because it is going to be cool. Guys, this is going to be fast. I have some skinny logs that are going to start off with, but we're going to be finishing on some big ones. This is right at 15 inch. We're almost at our 16 inch max. And this is going through an 8-way. Here we go. And these smaller logs, I might split them in half or I might just send them through here, because dealing with oak firewood, I think it's okay to have smaller pieces. It helps the customer out. So here's all you have to do right now. Sit back, turn up the volume, and watch this. That's that panel vibrating. Let me go turn it off. Okay, that was fun. So, I don't know, does that count as a jam? So that one log, it wouldn't go through. But what I did, I just hit it with the sledge, it popped right off, turned it the opposite way, and it ran it right through. So that is the first time I've ever used the sledgehammer, you know, to clear a jam. And when I had the 365, that was just part of my setup. I would have that sledgehammer there because it seemed like I was always gonna, you know, pound a round off of that knife that it wouldn't split. That's the first time ever, and you saw it live here at Ohio Woodburner. So let's take a look at our load of logs. And that was the eight way, but that was some bigger oak. It looks like a lot of red oak. I think that's all it was. Red oak. Yeah, I don't like the smell of it. It still doesn't smell good. And you know, you still got to watch yourself because these things will pop off or fall off and bang someone in the head. And that's what my camera girl, and I hope everyone can give her a thumbs up for this job, because when you're standing right here like where I am, you run the risk of a log, you know, tumbling back down and hitting you in the back of the head. Okay, that was fast work. I forgot to set the timer, so I don't know how long that took until after I review the film. And then I have the new bar put on. Metsa Machine sent me a new bar, and that was the problem. It's cutting great, but something happened. It was on about the second log. I don't know if it's going to show up on the video. I heard a ping, and I saw a spark shoot out. And I don't know if I had hit a nail or something, but it wasn't cutting as good as I was expecting. This is a brand new chain. Well, freshly sharpened chain. And it was chattery when I was cutting with it. It was shaking. So I must have damaged a tooth somewhere. But there you go. I thought that this would be a very fun run, and it was fun. This machine is just awesome. So my oak customers, they like the bigger pieces, and even though I'm running them through the eight way, you know, those bigger rounds, that 15 incher, the last one, those pieces came off pretty big. Those would be too big for the restaurants for, you know, my maple and cherry, but for the oak, this restaurant will be fine. These are just going to get stacked and they're going to sit. And there they are, guys. All right, I hope you like this. Just a different look. Clean, unedited. All for you. I hope everyone has a great day.